Welcome to the first product demo session. I'm from Lingraphica. My name is Bob Gonsalves. I'm one of the product engineers for the with Lingraphica. We're going to cover three areas today. We're going to first talk about the various free Lingraphica technologies. We have apps. We also have two websites that you can log into, get an account for free, and do some therapy on there. Our main product is the insurance reimbursable AAC devices, the multi-talk, all-talk, touch-talk. The third area I'll talk about is the free Lingraphica educational programs. We have two different programs, one more oriented towards SLPs, and the other oriented towards caregivers and their partners. We have to do the mandatory speaker disclosures. Both Mary Ann and I are employees of Lingraphica, and so we receive a salary from them. I'm going to talk first about the free technology solutions. We have Smalltalk apps, which are iOS only right now. TalkPath Therapy is a website where you can create an account and do therapy. I'll go into that in more detail. And then we also have TalkPath News, another website that you can sign into, and you can then read the news in a format that's suitable for people with aphasia. We currently have 14 Smalltalk apps. Thanks for bringing up the sound there. As I mentioned, they're all on iOS right now. They can be used as an adjunct to existing communication tools in support of therapy activities, and they can be used for very specific situations. I'll show you some of the examples here. We're in the process of developing these for Android, and which will occur probably sometime this year, maybe within the next 6 months or so. The Smalltalk communication apps allow a person with aphasia to communicate effectively across a variety of settings. For example, the pain scale is useful. It has an icon and a number underneath it. The icon shows various degrees of pain, starting from very little pain to excruciating pain, and makes it very easy for a person with aphasia to communicate that. There are also intensive care situations that allow a person with aphasia to communicate. And we have phrases both in English and Spanish, common communication phrases that you can use. The second category of Smalltalk apps are the speech exercise videos. So on these we have mouth position videos that allow the user to follow a person correctly pronouncing a word, and then they can mimic that back and practice their consonant blends, things like that. For the TalkPath Therapy, this is our website. It has 60 types of exercises, over 13,000 tasks. It's divided into two basic areas. We have language exercises, and we also have cognition exercises. Within the language section, we have four categories, as you can see: reading, writing, listening, and speaking. Cognition exercises include memory, reasoning, and activities of daily living. There are differing levels of difficulty within the exercises, and I'll show you how that works out. Here's an example of a writing exercise, a spelling level one. This is the simplest type of exercise. You can see that the keys that are not part of the answer are grayed out, so it reduces the cognitive load on the patient. There's an icon of an ear in there. You can click on it and hear it say ear. There are other hints. The yellow is a hint button. And the purple is a playback button, so you can play back the end result. All the patient has to do here is click on the letters in the correct order. They can also drag them down. Here's a more advanced version of the writing exercise. It's level 4. You can see that the word is much longer. It's not a 3-letter word. Also, all the keys on the keyboard are accessible, so it's they have to work harder to get the correct answer. The system records their good and false responses, and it can be set up for automatically advancing between levels, so that if they get 70%, for example, of an exercise correct, they can advance to a more difficult one. They only get 30%, they should drop down automatically to an easier exercise. This is very good for a homework. The clinician can set it up to either be automatically advancing or to stay at one particular level. The patient can work at their leisure at home using the website. I'm going to give you an example of one of the cognitive exercises. This is a city map. I'll wait a second for people to get settled down here. Okay. What they would do in this exercise is follow directions. It could be a simple instruction such as click on the bank, or it could be a more complicated instruction like take a right turn on this street, take a left turn on this street, and then click on the building that's there. Other examples that we have are menus, where they have to be able to read a menu and in response to a question, say click on a certain certain menu item, things like that. These are all good for activities of daily living. The memory exercises present an initial image usually, and then a delay of 5 seconds or so, and then a screen that says which of the images did you previously see. And we can control how long the delay is. We could also put additional foils in between to distract them and then make the task more difficult. The third part of our free offerings is the TalkPath News website. And here we collect articles. We publish 3 articles a day in various categories. We have national, world, what else? We have education, entertainment, health and lifestyle, science and technology, and history. No sports, though. And what happens is these go up on the website. You can sign up for this website for free. It's tpn.aphasia.com. And I'll show you how the news articles show up. There's a play button where you can advance through the sentences of each news article. And as it's advancing through, it highlights the sentence and helps to focus the patient. You can also rewind if you want to rehear a sentence, or fast forward if you get the gist already. This one's about a little boy who wants to ask his town to lift a snowball ban, a snowball fight ban, which I guess doesn't happen too often in Florida, but at the end of the reading the news articles, there are quizzes. They can be asked things about the content of the article. With assistance, they can get the sentence that has the answer highlighted. You can turn that off also. And then there are multiple choices. So Dane says he believes the law is what? Confusing, new, correct, or outdated? In this case, Dane thinks it's outdated. We also have a TalkPath News Facebook group. And people get together and work together on the news stories. We also see this in user groups. People will get together and work on the stories, encourage each other, try to explain things if somebody else is not getting it, things like that. We also have a variety of AAC devices. They range in size from a small 4-inch tablet to a laptop with a keyboard attached, which also has a tablet mode. I'll show you briefly what the interface looks like here. At the top, you can see a toolbar. There's a search feature where you can search for icons, a quick communication area, that's what that lightning bolt in the blue there is. The type and talk in the purple keyboard allows you to compose sentences and hit a button and it'll automatically create an icon for you that speaks. You can take camera images and there's a whiteboard feature also. Down below you see our dictionary. It consists of several thousand icons. The images that you're seeing here are pages. You can tell that because there's a border that goes around them. We have a little video that we recorded previously that shows how the AAC device is used, so we'll go over that. So the button bar at top, hitting the home button here. And these were customized categories. We provide built-in categories, but the system is very customizable. You can create your own icons and so on.
I live in Florida, on a small island off the Gulf of Mexico, with our two cats named Annie and Alex, and my husband Mike.
I have two cats also.
Do you?
Yeah. So we'll show an example of how to create a custom icon here. One thing you might have noticed is that the text underneath the icon was short, but the utterance was much longer. This interface shows how that's accomplished. You can type something, a short label in the top area, and then type something longer in the bottom area, and that's what's going to be pronounced. Also, we're showing some of the predictive capabilities of our keyboard. As you use the keyboard, it learns what you've typed and will predict what the next word will be for you. Here we're going through our icon inventory. Represent hot, we'll use this icon here. And so now we have our new icon.
Summer is really hot.
The presentation could be video. It has that capability. It can be a still picture. With built-in camera, you can take pictures of what's going on around you. And so these are the, gives you an idea of the relative sizes of the three different models that we sell. Okay, the third overall category I'm going to talk about is the training programs that we offer. These are all free also. We have the Lingraphica certification program, and we have the ACE program, Achieving Communication Excellence. I'll tell you to do that. Come back here. All right. So the Lingraphica certification program is primarily oriented towards speech-language pathologists. There are four aspects to it. We provide a device for you to work with. We provide you access to the TalkPath Therapy and the TalkPath News websites. And we also have a tool called the Quick Assess. And it's used to evaluate whether a patient is appropriate for one of our devices, or whether our device is appropriate for our patients, let's put it that way. And so they can quickly go through the screens and see if the patient can actually use the device or not. Like I mentioned, we provide the SLP with the hardware and all the software, and we provide the guidance on and training on how to use all of those things. You can earn up to 3.4 ASHA CEUs. The second free program is Achieving Communication Excellence. The ACE program is for our communication device owners. It's for our caregivers as well as the patients. It's our attempt to deal with device abandonment, which is a common problem in AAC devices. We want to make sure that the patients are getting the best use of the device possible, and so we provide as much support as possible. That's about it, except we do have one other session. That'll be early tomorrow at 8 a.m. We're going to talk about multicultural inclusion and what we've been doing insofar as adding those sort of features to our devices. That'll be AAC 55. It's in the Caribbean room at 8 a.m. We also have a booth here. We're at booth 812, which is right about there. And love for you to come by and look at the devices, get a hands-on, look at the various features, ask us questions, things like that. And that's all I have. If you want to fill out a session evaluation form, we are AAC 53. And here are our bios for your amusement or interest. Thanks very much for attending our session.